Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. My name is Monica, and today I'm actually doing my very first original tag. I'm really excited. I've always wanted to do a tag, but like the topics, I don't know, I never came across a topic that interested me enough, also that like other people hadn't already done, and I finally did. So I'm calling this the part-time YouTuber tag. So this isn't a beauty YouTube specific tag. This is basically a tag that anyone can do so long as you do YouTube part-time. And what I mean by that is, do you have a full-time job? Do you go to school full-time? Are you a parent? Do you have anything else outside of YouTube other than like having YouTube as your full-time job? Which that's not a bad thing, but I feel like we don't really focus as a community, maybe YouTube as a whole, we don't focus as much on, of course, your life outside of YouTube. And I thought this was really interesting, especially since through my last Q&A, through my last like the bookshelf tour, a lot of people are really interested in this. And I thought to myself, I'm interested about other people too, because I know a lot of my YouTube friends, they don't do YouTube full time. They've got lives outside of YouTube. And I thought this would be the perfect way to learn more about our YouTube friends. So this tag has 8 questions. I will have all of them listed down below, and I will also tag some of my YouTube friends, but I really tag anyone who is interested, anyone who watches this video to do the tag along with me. Okay, so question number 1 is, what is your main gig? Do you work full-time? Are you a student, a parent? Spill the beans. So my main gig is my full-time job. I am an editorial assistant, which is kind of like a junior editor at a publishing company. If you want to add me on LinkedIn, feel free. But I do work in publishing, and before that I used to work at a bookstore. It was a Barnes & Noble College location. So my main career, my main job is within publishing. And if you want to hear a little bit more about it, check out my last Q&A video. I'll have it up in the cards because I do get into a little bit more detail there about what I kind of do like on a day-to-day basis. Question number 2 is, what made you want to start YouTube? And this is something that I talk a little bit more about in some of my other videos, but for this tag, I was watching a lot of YouTube, and I was seeing these creators, and I was seeing some smaller creators, which really inspired me. Like, if they could have a channel, and they could have so much fun with this, and not have 100 million subscribers, you know, but they were still having fun, and they were enjoying it, like, I was like, why can't I do that? Why don't I do that? So, that was, like, the push I needed, was actually seeing smaller creators, and seeing people become friends, and I just wanted to be a part of the community. To be quite honest, I wanted to make friends, I wanted to talk to people, and I was able to accomplish all of that. Sure, my channel isn't huge, but I've made awesome friends, and I've got a great community here, and I love it. Question number 3 is, what is your channel about? Do you stick to one niche, or do you cover a few? So I put this in here to cover some of the other channels, because any channel can do this, even if you're not a beauty community channel. So I just wanted to have that in here, just to talk a little bit more about your channel. So of course, my channel is focused on beauty, but at the beginning, if you go to my very first videos, you'll see my tagline was books and beauty, because I thought I could be like a half booktube, half beauty channel. I ended up kind of cutting that out since books are like my career and my job, and I kind of wanted YouTube to be a bit different from that. So I stuck with the beauty, but I do have a few videos here and there, including my book tour, my Q&A, a few things here and there where I talk more about books and my career. Hiccup. So for the niche, or do you cover a few? I feel like I'm fairly solidly, I don't know, I call myself a small beauty creator because I kind of cover a lot of things. I do reviews, I do project panning, I do shop my stash, I still do hauls, I still like to shop. So I'm not a minimalist, but I'm not someone who shops constantly. So I feel like I'm kind of like in the middle. Question number 4 is, did you always know YouTube would be a side gig, or did/do you ever want to be a full-time YouTuber? Ever since I started, I knew, and I do know, that YouTube will never be my full-time job. I really aspire, even if my channel like got big or anything, I would aspire to be like Christine from Simply Neurological, where she still has her daytime job. Even though she makes way more on YouTube, she keeps the job because she respects her education and her career and wants to continue with it. And I respect the hell out of that. So that's how I always pictured myself if my channel ever got big. It's not gonna get big, but I love the community here, I love the friends that I've made, but it's always going to be my hobby. This is never going to be like my full-time thing. Question number 5, can I count? Yes, it is number 5. What is your schedule like? When do you film and when do you edit? So, I work Monday through Friday at my full-time job. I am allowed to work from home one day a week and still have my job in the office. It's a weird thing. I actually don't like working from home, but it's mainly because I don't actually have, like, a full desk or an office. Whenever I work from home, I sit here at my vanity and I work. If I had a separate part in my house where I could sit and, like, specifically work, then I think I would like working from home more often, but I really don't like it. I like going into the office, even if the commute is kind of blur. So I'm allowed to work from home one day a week. That used to be Fridays, but I am switching my schedule now where I'll be working from home on Thursdays and then going into the office on Fridays. And I like to film in the morning before I either start working at home or before I go to catch the train. So today I'm filming this on a Friday. So I'm actually going to catch a train in like 25 minutes. I have to be out the door. So I like to film like first thing in the morning, makeup is fresh, even if I'm sweating, it's still hot. I cannot wait for fall to actually be fall. But I film first thing in the morning, either my tutorials or my looks or whatever it is. I film it in the morning, put away all of my filming equipment, go to work. I do my thing at work. I don't know what that is, but I do my thing at work. I come home. And then normally after I have dinner is when I will sit down and start editing. I will combine my audio and video files. I will start editing. I'll do thumbnails. I'll schedule videos. So that kind of is at nighttime. I specifically carve out time on Friday and Saturday to spend with family, friends, and my boyfriend. But I kind of try to keep my weeknights open unless something big comes up, just so I have the time to relax after work and to do some editing work if I want to. But my main editing day has become Sunday, because that's kind of my stay-at-home, do laundry, clean, whatever day. That's when I do a lot of my editing, especially when I'm pre-filming, because I am still pre-filming before my vacation a little bit later this week. So when I pre-film like that, Sundays are a huge help like that. Question number 6 is, how do you keep your YouTube channel organized? Do you plan videos ahead of time or just film what you feel like? I'm definitely a planner. I will throw a quick screenshot up. I will go into more detail. I'm actually planning to do a video of just about my whole YouTube process, because I've had a lot of questions about that, about my filming setup, about my scheduling, about my everything. But this is just a quick preview of my Google Doc. So I have a Google Doc where I keep a calendar and I plan things out weeks ahead of time. I did my best to get an actual planner and like pencil things in and work like that, but I change things so often that it wasn't really feasible or workable. So a Google Doc works best for me. And you can see in the Google Doc, I have a lot of like color-coded things. So I actually have a color code, a chart? I don't know what the word is, but I color code everything. So if you see anything highlighted in blue, that's what I'm going to be filming next. And I normally put the day I want to film it in parentheses. If it's yellow, I have filmed it, but it has not been edited or touched yet. If it's green, it is fully edited, but it is not uploaded to YouTube yet. And if it's purple, the video has been edited, uploaded, the description box, the cards, end cards, everything is done and it's ready to go. That way I can just at a glance look at my schedule and see, okay, what do I have to do today? What's already scheduled? What's just like filmed? What do I have to edit? It's a really easy way to just get a full look at everything that I'm doing. And I also like to keep track of what's going on in like my personal life. So like in red, I will have, if I'm off work that day, I will have a note because I can get more work done for YouTube that day. If I am out of town on a work trip, if I'm out of town on vacation, I like plan that in so I can keep an eye on what do I have to make sure is done and scheduled before I'm out, you know? So I feel like I definitely plan my videos ahead of time, but sometimes I plan what's inside the actual video. I don't write scripts. I'm not the kind of channel that needs to write a script for every video, but I do have to be mindful of what I'm going to film. If it's a tag, it's a bit easier because I can just answer the questions as I go. But if it's like a shot my stash, I have to get a different tripod out and I have to make sure I have the lights and everything set up for that. Or if I'm doing a couple looks, one palette. That's probably gonna take me a couple of days to film. So I need to film like one look this day, two looks that day, and then get everything together at the end. If it is like a haul video, I have to make sure I actually have all the products together. If it's a video that I'm doing, even if it's a tag that includes products, I make sure I gather the products ahead of time and just have them kind of near me so I don't have to do this right before I'm filming, because I do have a very limited time slot for when I can film. So it's all about being prepared, it's all about being planned. But that being said, I change things constantly, so it's not set in stone. Like yesterday, I actually filmed, so this is the day after I put out my video about hitting pan in a blush. That was a spontaneous video because I finally hit pan in a blush for the first time. So I changed things around there, and then I decided to do a tag today because I had the inspiration to do my own tag. I wanted to do this kind of as a bonus video, but since that happened, I switched things up. So I'm constantly moving around things in my Google Doc, which is easy for me to do since it's a Google Doc. And it's also easily accessible on my phone. I can bring it with me. I can keep an eye on it. It's so helpful. And I'm so glad I used a Google Doc instead of, you know, trying to keep using the planner that I bought. It was a waste of money on the planner, but I learned what works best for me. Question number 7 is, how do you feel about sponsored videos on YouTube? Have you / would you ever do one on your channel? I threw this in because I feel like it's kind of a big, it's an odd topic in certain communities on YouTube. Like within the beauty community, sponsored videos are handled and received a lot differently than they are within, I feel like, the rest of YouTube, the gaming community, the video essay community, booktubes, you know? I feel like it's received differently since the beauty community is so much more focused on products and how they perform. So I am perfectly fine with sponsored videos so long as they are clearly and plainly disclosed. I have the biggest problem. I've seen this a few times, actually. There's a curly hair YouTuber that I follow, and she released a video, and it was all about, like, taking care of a dry scalp. And, like, the title, I will look up the exact title. It said, like, the best clarifying routine for your scalp, or something like that. And I was like, oh my god, that's exactly what I'm looking for. This is great. I click into the video, and it sounds like an ad. But there was no ad disclosed. I look at the top of the description box, I don't see anything. And so I watch half of it, and then it's plainly obvious to me that this is a paid sponsored video, but she has not disclosed it yet. So I watch the rest of the video. These are products that she's using for the first time, which she specified in the video. She's only used these products once or twice. Sponsored video. And I'm just like, what are you doing? Like, why are you talking about the great benefits of these products when you've literally used them for the first time the day you're filming this? And I finish the video, I have a bad taste in my mouth, I go to the very bottom of the description box. She's got a lot of stuff. So the very bottom is where it says, thank you to blah 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 for sponsoring this video. That I have a problem with. That you are deliberately misleading your audience for money. Like, for money, you're convincing us to try and buy products that you haven't even thoroughly tested out. You literally just had this company email you, send you a check and the products, and then you're like, oh, I'll just do a video. Like, no. They need to be thoroughly disclosed, and you need to actually, like, test the product out. Those are the only two things I expect from a sponsored video, and it's astonishing how many YouTubers cannot hit those. So that being said, I would accept sponsorships if and only if they were from companies that I trusted and would allow me the space to do exactly what I said, actually try the products out, give my full thoughts on them, and I would plainly and clearly disclose it. And the last question, question number 8, is what do you think is the biggest challenge of doing YouTube part-time? So I think the biggest challenge was just figuring out my schedule and figuring out really how many videos a week I could handle. Because I was originally in the middle of like early 2019, mid 2019, I was doing 5 videos a week. And with my job getting a little bit more intense and more work heavy, 5 videos a week were not feasible for me. And I ended up kind of like breaking down and like freaking out. And it wasn't just that I wanted to stick to my schedule. I felt like I was letting myself down. and I was letting my subscribers down, but really I was helping myself by moving to 3 videos a week, because now I have more time to put more effort into better edited, better filmed, better thought out, better planned videos, and I've gained more than 500 subscribers, you know, since I've cut down. And my biggest fear was that if by doing that, I was going to lose subscribers, which is stupid, because it's definitely better to put more thought into fewer videos a week than to, like, kill yourself and work so hard to throw out, like, barely passing videos 5 times a week. So I think one of the biggest challenges of doing YouTube specifically part-time is figuring out your schedule. What can you handle? What can you do? Because it is a lot of work. Outside of my job, I put at least 20 hours a week into YouTube. And that's with the three videos a week. Because you can even imagine what I was trying to do with 5 videos a week. So that's the whole tag. And my voice just cracked. So that's the whole tag. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please, if you have a YouTube channel, if you do it part-time, please do this tag. I would love to see other people do this on YouTube, and I will be creating a playlist that I will have on my channel, and if you do a video, I will add it to that playlist, and I'll promote it in the description box, and if I do an update video, I'll just have that there. I can also put it on my community tab. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm so excited. Don't forget to let me know down below if you do this tag, or tag some of your other favorite YouTubers to do this. I would love to see that. Thank you guys for watching, and I cannot wait to see you in my next video. Bye.